बीएससी करने के बाद एमबीए कर सकते हैं क्या?
What questions you should answer before you join a B school? Should we go for our MBA this year or should we wait?
सर मैं ऑनलाइन एमबीए करने के लिए फुल टाइम एमबीए के पैसे क्यों
दूं? Why MBA? Should we go for MBA in India or abroad? How should they expect their return on investment? Hello everyone. Good afternoon, sat sri akal, namaskar, ram ram. And in today's session we have a special guest.
देखो आपके लिए स्पेशल है, मेरे लिए स्पेशल है, आप पहली बार मिलोगे, बट मेरे बहुत अच्छे मित्र हैं,
वेरी गुड फ्रेंड, वंडरफुल पर्सनालिटी, सम क्रेडेंशियल्स एंड एवरीथिंग इज ऑलरेडी बीन देयर. सो लेट्स मीट द फॉर्मर डायरेक्टर मार्केटिंग माइक्रोसॉफ्ट इंडिया, फाउंडर ऑफ ऑक्टेन रिसर्च, और बाकी अगर मैं उनके बारे में बोलना शुरू करूंगा तो मैं बोलता रहूंगा. हाय पुनीत.
हेलो, नमस्ते गौरव.
Let's meet our students. We have a number of live learners who have already come for the session. Why don't you talk about yourself, sir, first?
आप मुझे बहुत अच्छी तरह already जानते हो, लेकिन जो पहली बार मुझे देख रहे हैं आपके चैनल पे और स्क्रीन पे, I think it'll be good if I just showed a slide or two. उससे context setting हो जाएगी तो फिर लोगों के सारे questions काफी resolve हो जाएंगे. भाई है कौन ही है बंदा? So in a nutshell, I'm currently responsible for two brands. Octane Research, which is my own entrepreneurship journey, which is my journey of my mind, where I research into how marketeers are using technology in India. So MBA Spark is the journey of my heart, and that's to help young MBAs become industry ready. This is an MBA leadership program. So this is what essentially the sort of two things I do right now. And if you look at my professional profile, there are two parallel tracks. Like a railway track. One track is my professional journey as a corporate executive. I've been blessed to work for good brands like NIIT, Oracle, Talisma, Microsoft, wow. MSN, and all this across multiple geographies. So you can see San Francisco, London, you can see Sydney, you can see Bengaluru, Delhi, and of course you see Ranchi. So that's the roots I come from. I come from the same school as Dhoni.
Oh wow.
My interesting guy. He's my junior. Same school though. So this is my little one track, which is about corporate executive, MNC jobs, multiple locations, leadership roles. And the other is that of my parallel track of being an entrepreneur. Mm-hmm. So I've done three companies before this, before MBA Spark and Octane Research, and two of them have been successful. So a lot of what I share with you in my session today is coming from one, my own personal journey, but more importantly, a lot of MBA journeys around me. Since 2000-2001, I've been actively hiring and recruiting young professionals straight from campus. And I know, Gaurav, you're passionate about this entire campus to career journey. कि भाई campus में तो अच्छी बात है, लेकिन career कैसे बनेगा?
Right sir.
तो उसका जो gap bridge करना है, उसपे आप बहुत काम करते हो. And this is the reason I also love to be on a session like this with you. So that's my journey where I have worked with many young professionals, and hopefully I'll be able to share some ideas. So this is MBA Spark. MBA Leadership Program, 6-Pack MBA. You can watch a lot more things on our social media channels, YouTube, LinkedIn, etc. But the main reason we are here is to discuss this, questions to ask before joining an MBA program. Now, let me stop sharing and back to you now, Gaurav.
So first and foremost, make the agenda very clear. कुछ सवाल तो ऑलरेडी हमने सोचे हुए हैं जो हम आपसे पूछेंगे. एट द सेम टाइम द सेशन इज लाइव, अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल आस्किंग क्वेश्चंस व्हिच आर वेरी टेक्निकल क्वेश्चंस आल्सो. सो वन ऑफ द स्टूडेंट्स सेड दैट यू नो बीएससी करने के बाद एमबीए कर सकते हैं क्या, ऐसे क्वेश्चंस भी उठाएंगे बाद में. और कुछ ऐसे भी हैं वे देवयानी इज आस्किंग दैट पुनीत सर हाउ वी बिकम सो सक्सेसफुल एज यू आर. सो सम इंटरेस्टिंग क्वेश्चंस आर गोना कम. मैं सारे स्टूडेंट्स को बता देता हूँ कि एजेंडा अपना बिल्कुल क्लियर है. आप फर्स्ट ईयर स्टूडेंट हो सकते हैं, आप वो स्टूडेंट हो सकते हैं हु हैज टेकन ऑलरेडी यू नो ऑल एग्जामिनेशन एंड नाउ गोइंग फॉर एमबीए. तो आप इनमें से कोई सा भी स्टूडेंट हो सकते हैं. दिस इंटरेक्शन, दिस सेशन, दिस कॉन्वर्सेशन, ये जो वार्तालाप है, ये सारा आप ही के लिए है. टिपिकली हमारा एजेंडा आज का ये है, व्हाट क्वेश्चंस यू शुड आंसर बिफोर यू ज्वाइन अ बी स्कूल. And then we have an expert here. We have our guest here, Mr. Puneet Modgil, who's been with Microsoft, Oracle, good entrepreneurial journey. And most importantly, I tell you, he's been a recruiter in number of B schools where you aspire to go. So, jab Puneet sir, jab aap recruiter ke ek mindset se kisi B school mein enter hote honge, so obviously, you know, you see something in a student. So I must say that, you know, that same thing a college also sees in a student, ki bhi right raw material mil jaye humko. right? So from that perspective, we're going to talk about a lot of things. And before we start, I must congratulate rather the entire Unacademy team, you know, that we could have you here today with us. So representing Unacademy, me, Gaurav Sharma, I have, you know, you with us today. So we have certain questions, sir. Most sensitive topic uthate hain, sir, sabse pehle COVID-19. Okay, let's talk about not much, but a little. A lot of students have this doubt. Should we go for our MBA this year or should we wait? This question is somewhere related to one more question jahan pe nikal ke laate hain ek sawal ke sir kuch din main thoda agar work ex bhi le lu to mera you know covid bhi nikal jayega thoda ek saal ka experience bhi ho jayega. Obviously they're not wrong somewhere or the other. Bahut hi sensitive sa par bahut hi mushkil sa sawal hai. So what should they do? Should they be picking up their MBA right away or should they wait for covid to pass? Or what is your thoughts, sir?
That's a very time sensitive question and there's no one answer. It's a very personal journey. So jo log MBA karne aate hain, people who decide to do an MBA, they have a reason why they have chosen to do an MBA. There are freshers who have decided to do an MBA because they've done their bachelor's and sequentially they want to get done with the MBA also, with the master's also. So they are job ready. Then there are industry professionals who have been working for 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 years and now they want to add new skills. So COVID-19 is a disruption. And many students are also writing to me, sir, main online MBA karne ke liye full-time MBA ke paise kyun do?
Right.
Which is a very legit question, right? Because if classes online ho rahi hain, so I can go to an online portal and do an online MBA. So why should I put money into a program which will cost me a lot of time and energy and money as well? Or wo online hi hoga. So I look at it, there are two possibilities. There is Corona, COVID-19, even this 2021 batch will be impacted to some extent. So should I join a full-time MBA program right now? Or should I take a drop year? So let's evaluate both options. Even if I join the COVID-19 sort of impacted batch, by the way, last year batch, 2020 to 2022 batch was the COVID batch. You're not the COVID batch, you're COVID plus one batch if you join MBA this year. So by the time you come towards your internship, which is next year, next summer of 2022, for full-time internship, it wouldn't be this bad. I think last year's COVID batch, there was a lot of uncertainty, unknown. There is uncertainty right now, but not unknown. Now we know what to take care of and how to take precautions. So the recovery this time will be faster. My sense is COVID will have lesser impact on this year's batch. It joins from June, July onwards and graduates in the summer of 2023. So that's one. So you will have an impact. You may have 3, 4, 5 months of online MBA, but this will not last the 18 months, 20 months, 24 months of full online MBA.
Right, right. Absolutely.
When you join a campus program, the experience is very different. This cannot be replicated in online. And if you're already working in a company and you think that you can serve better scores, better prep next year, please be so. So there's no right or wrong answer. I don't think if you don't have a job, if you're not employment ready, if you're graduating with a BBA degree and you're not sure, but if you've got good campus recruitment this year, I don't think you should stop yourself from joining that.
Absolutely correct, sir. And all of us know that the first question we come to the student, which is the most important question also, that is why MBA? So please throw some light on this, that when students start preparing for this answer also, rather when they think about it, that, you know, why am I doing MBA? So give them some dots where they can connect and they can, you know, compare by themselves. That should we go for MBA or not? Because this is the first question. Either they come for CAT preparation, they invest money in that, they invest their time in that. After that, going for B school, 10 lakh, 20 lakh, 25 lakh. Why MBA? What do you think? So why should a student look for MBA and why not?
So there are two types of, again, professionals or young managers who do MBA. One is freshers who are not ready for a job, who are not aware about what happens in companies, in business, and they want to become better. So they graduate with a BTech degree, with a bachelor's in arts, sciences or commerce or BBA, and they want to join a full-time program. So their journey is slightly different from, you know, what are you hoping to gain? Because they feel that they can be industry ready immediately. Mm-hmm. So, you know, they spent 2 years and they're industry ready. The second category of students are people who are already working in a company. 4, 5 years, 3 years, they're going for an exec MBA, full-time MBA, doesn't matter, but they're going for a one-year MBA program. They want to increase the velocity of their career journey. Mm-hmm. They want to see what are the other options. I may be a finance professional, I may be a chartered accountant. There are doctors, Gaurav, I've seen who have done MBBS. they are GP in hospitals, then they go for an MBA program. Wow. I've seen all sorts of combinations. So they want to broaden their horizon. They're working in a typical hospital as a practitioner. They want to see how hospital administration works. Or I'm a finance person. I've done enough of chartered accountancy and finance function. Can I see what all other exist roles exist in a company? Can I move my career track into different gear? So these are two types of broadly categories.
I would like you to add one more category, sir. Sorry to interrupt. Just one more category where a student of BSc Biotech, you know, there are some learners live with me. They're asking like, you know, BBA, is it like mandatory after BBA going for MBA? Or like, you know, BSc after BSc MBA, how would they match? So the categories you, you know, just picked up, I would like to give you this category also once, please.
People have done their bachelor's not knowing where to go. And after the bachelor's, they've realized, maine BSc Biotech to kar liya, lekin wo mera calling nahi hai. I'm 22, 23, 21. I know this is not where I want to be. So MBA does give you that option to do a lateral shift. MBA is a, you know, forgiving program. It does not judge you from what you've done before.
Okay.
Once you join the program, it's like a sadhana for 2 years. It's a self-transformational journey for 2 years. It's not a certificate journey. So if you're coming to do an MBA to take an MBA degree on your profile, then, you know, go for do any MBA, doesn't matter. But if you want to gain personally, professionally, aapka career 20-25-30 saal to hoga aage.
Right.
Uske liye agar aap plan kar rahe ho ki how can this help me?
Mm-hmm.
So, then we can discuss more.
Oh, very right, sir. Very right. A lot of students, many times they ask, should we go for MBA in India or abroad? A very basic question. And this question comes in picture. Why? Because of the competition. Now, lakhs of students are taking CAT. Few IIMs, you know, now baby IIMs are also there, you know, we call them now Blackie and now baby IIMs. But still, there's huge competition, which doesn't say that people who do not make it, they do not have it. So, is competition ko answer karne ke liye, kai baar ek thought aata hai students ko, that should we look for MBA abroad also? So, relocating. You know, from my city to different city, now I'm going to different city, can I look for beyond my country also? What is your opinion on this, sir?
It's a very, again, very, very personal question, but there are three types of programs right now you can find in the market. One is you leave India and you go and do your MBA from Australia, Canada, New Zealand, US, UK, Germany. Second is you do an MBA in India. And there are hybrid programs, by the way,
wow,
which help you allow you to spend some time of the 2 year program outside of India. 1 semester, 3 months, 6 months, sometimes even longer.
Mm.
So there are three models, pure overseas, pure India and hybrid. And there are advantages. So let's discuss advantages of stepping outside of India. You get a newer perspective. You get challenged in ways more than one. Dal, roti, aata, sab kuch aapko khud karna padega. You are learning new things. You're learning 24/7. It'll challenge you, push you in directions that you do not even know because you're new to culture, you're new to society, and on top of that, you don't have a lot of money to spend. So you'll gain a lot. Academically, if you leave aside the top 20 B schools globally, which are the best, which do not take freshers, by the way, they will require you to have at least 4-5 years of experience.
Okay.
So world's top 20 best B schools are mostly outside of India and do have at least 4-5 years of work experience prerequisite.
As a prerequisite.
So if you want to learn, तो अगर आपको कुछ बहुत कुछ सीखना है, lifestyle सीखना है, कैसे लोग काम करते हैं बाहर, वो सब जो understanding सीखनी है, तो India से बाहर experience अच्छी बात है. Expensive बहुत है, loan आपका बहुत बढ़ जाएगा. और कई बार तो जो banks हैं यहाँ के loan भी नहीं देंगे आपको बाहर MBA करने के लिए. So personal investments have to be made. But lot of sacrifice, lodging cost, boarding cost, बहुत कुछ रहेगा. लेकिन आपको सीखने को बहुत मिलेगा. On the other side, अगले 20-30 साल की जो मार्केट है दुनिया भर में, कंज्यूमर मार्केट, ग्रोथ मार्केट, इंडस्ट्री ग्रोथ, वो या तो चाइना और इंडिया. तो अगर आप इंडिया से एमबीए करते हैं तो ऐसा नहीं कि आपको ग्रोथ अपॉर्चुनिटी इंडिया में कम मिलेगी. मेरे कितने दोस्त हैं, आई एम कलकत्ता से हैं, जिस कैंपस से आप हैं, और बहुत सारे कैंपस से हैं, IBS से हैं, ISB से हैं, और इंडिया से बाहर भी काम कर रहे हैं. ऐसा कुछ नहीं है कि अगर आपने इंडिया का एमबीए किया तो आप इंडिया में रुक गए. और अगर आपने बाहर का एमबीए किया तो ये बहुत जरूरी है कि फिर इंडिया में आके इंटर्नशिप करोगे क्या आप? फिर इंडिया में आके जॉब करोगे तो आपकी सैलरी इंडिया वाली रहेगी और आपके खर्चे जो हो गए वो डॉलर्स में हो गए और दिनार्स में हो गए उसमें हो गए. सो देयर इज अ थर्ड ऑप्शन व्हिच इज द प्रेफर्ड ऑप्शन. और बहुत सारे कैंपसेस कर रहे हैं, MDI गुड़गांव ये करता है, बहुत सारे सिस्टर स्कूल्स हैं, आई थिंक IIM इंदौर भी कर रहा है अभी तो, और चितकारा भी करता है,
SP जैन
इनके MAD तो करते हैं, SP जैन करता है, सो यू कैन स्पेंड 1-2 quarters आउटसाइड ऑफ इंडिया. तो जैसे MDI गुड़गांव हैज एफिलिएशन विद INSEAD फ्रांस एंड सिंगापुर, यू कैन गो एंड स्पेंड 1 full semester. तो अगर कैट नहीं हुआ तो GMAT है, सही बात है आपकी, लेकिन कैट और GMAT नहीं भी हुआ अगर बढ़िया तो कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं है. आप MBA के दौरान व्हाट यू डू इन द 2-year MBA इज एज इम्पोर्टेंट एज जॉइनिंग अ गुड कैंपस. यहाँ पे हम लोग मार खा जाते हैं, हम लोग MBA पे इतना फिक्सेटेड हो जाते हैं कि कैट मेरा परसेंटाइल 97.9 आया तो मुझे मिला नहीं बेस्ट कैट, बेस्ट IIM. बट व्हाट यू डू इन दैट कैंपस प्रोग्राम फॉर 2 years, दैट ऑल्सो मैटर्स.
राइट.
In fact, in my experience, that matters more than the overall credibility and the reputation of the institute. What you do in that 2-year MBA.
So what you've just said, that's absolutely correct. Now, before that, when you used a term called dollars and dinars and rupees also, that is where I'm coming on to, which is a very important question. When people think about rate, return on investment, they invest lakhs in India for going for B school, for MBA. How should they expect the return on investment? What is this theory of return on investment? Paisa lagaya maine, main kitna package nikalu yahan se? For an instance, at very first step, I do not understand this because, aap usko interest pe nahi dal rahe ho paise ko. Pehle to aapne kitna invest kiya khud ko 2 saal mein, wo important hai. Still, at the same time, what is your opinion on return on investment theory? I hope all the learners must have got this question.
Gaurav, ye education pe ROI na bada tricky subject hai. लोग PhD करते हैं, मास्टर्स करते हैं तो उस पर क्या ROI होता है, लोग BTech करके घर बैठे हैं तो उस पर ROI कैसे निकाला. बट आपका क्वेश्चन वैलिड है बिकॉज मेनी ऑफ द स्टूडेंट्स विल टेक लोन्स फॉर द MBA जर्नी. सो एक बात तो बड़ी क्लियर है कि MBA प्रोग्राम ऑफर्स द बेस्ट ROI ऑफ ऑल मास्टर्स प्रोग्राम्स, MBBS इंक्लूडेड बाय द वे.
राइट.
2 साल के MBA में जितना भी आप पैसा खर्च करेंगे उसकी ROI आपको बेस्ट मिलेगी इन ऑल मास्टर्स प्रोग्राम्स, नंबर वन. Number two, the ROI is of two types. The ROI is that of immediately ROI, package CTC. And the second ROI spread over next 20-25 years. So MBAs do have a different career journey from non-MBAs. And within MBAs, different tier systems will give you a different head start. Ek bar aap job mein lag gaye, bar aap place ho gaye, so fir next jobs will not come because just because you're from a good camp. So there is two investments, immediate ROI and long-term ROI. Immediate ROI packages you will get when you graduate. But in my view, that also, there's a very myopic view. Hamare jo young MBA students hain jinhone kaam nahi kiya, wo sirf usi pe fixated ho jate hain ki average city se dikha raha hai 10 lakh is campus ka. But wo average hai, wo aapko nahi milne wala hai. Pehli baat, aap average hai nahi, aap average se upar hain. और वो एवरेज भी जो जिस तरह कैलकुलेट होता है वो बड़ा मिस्टीरियस सा है वो.
इट्स नॉट वेरी ब्लैक, दैट्स अ वेरी डिफरेंट डिस्कशन ऑल टुगेदर.
तो ROI इन माय व्यू इट्स राइट, द मनी यू पुट इन गौरव एंड द रिटर्न यू गेट. सो समटाइम्स फॉर एग्जांपल इफ यू गो टू अ बनस्थली MBA, यू स्पेंड 5 lakh rupees ओवर 2 years एंड मोर लाइकली यू विल गेट अ जॉब 5-7 lakh rupees. सो इट्स अ ग्रेट ROI वर्सेस यू पुट 20 lakh rupees एंड यू स्टिल गेट अ 8 lakh rupee जॉब अ ईयर. सो दैट्स अ डिफरेंट ROI. बट एक लॉन्ग टर्म पोटेंशियल भी है. So many a times I feel when students are deciding on their MBA journeys, they're too fixated on the CTC, the first job. The first job may be a great job, not good CTC, but the acceleration that you will get in that job is phenomenal. So wo entry ticket ke liye bhi aapko MBA chahiye, otherwise they will not even hire you. So it's right. Very unlikely they'll hire a BBA student for that role. So there are many ways to calculate the ROI, but MBA programs have two folds, theory and practical, industry experience. That industry experience is incredibly important. So ROI is fabulous. Best ROI for any master's program.
Okay. Yeah, right. Something out of this topic or the theme you're taking, because one of the students asked a very interesting question that there are a number of books we can see behind your back, sir. So which is your favorite book?
So kitabe bahut sari yahan pe, agar aap mujhe genre denge to I can help you pick one. But if you ask me which is the most under-hyped book that I have read recently and many times over, it has to be Srimad Bhagavad Gita. You can read it like a religious text, or you can read it like a good story which inspires you. And I must tell you, there are scientists, there are physicists, there are people I've met who are not from India, and they have been inspired by this beautiful work of work of book that you can lay your hands on. So everybody in the world, 35 plus Marathiyon ne apne apne versions nikale hain,
right,
they've done,
right,
done their own.
Yeah, including
that, that'll be my as well.
So all these Arjunas would like to ask a question to their Krishna, who's here with us today. You know, some more questions, like, you know, some people have this doubt, you know, not a doubt, but, you know, we would want you to give a clarity on something called internships. Sometimes a college course, either it's a BBA or BCA, BTech, it demands. And sometimes, like I suggest, if it doesn't demand also, you should always look for internships and projects. How important internship is when it is, when we talk about going for an MBA later, what kind of an investment it is?
Interestingly, when I did my research right now, we've just launched a research study on state of internships in India, state of MBA internships in India. Tomle pichle 4-5 mahine mein, we reached out to 350 plus MBA seniors who graduated in the last 5 to 7 years are working in corporates. So we asked them about their internship experience and what they would recommend to fresh young MBA students, or we call them young managers, who are yet to start their MBA journey or who are in the first or second year. We asked academic institutions, B-school deans and professors, what do you think internship should be and what do you think, how can interns be better? We asked corporates, 50 plus leading employers of India, we asked them, what would you like to see in an intern? So that report is downloadable on mbaspark.com. You can just get your free copy if you are watching this even later or even live. But internship, so we also ask a simple question to them saying, in your placement interview, which happens in the second year around September, October timeframe, by December, January, the placements, which is when you get the job offer, that session closes and you join a company April onwards when you graduated an MBA degree. So placement season, the activity typically is focused in the last 6 months. But here is an interesting point, Gaurav. How much of the placement interview, what percentage of the placement interview for MBA is around your internship experience? Wow. A prospective employer shortlists your resume from the resume book of 400 MBAs from your campus. Aapka interview hota hai. Aapke interview mein kitna interview ka jo content hai, wo aapke internship pe discussion hoga. 70% or more.
Okay. All right. Okay.
And this is the part where most MBAs from non-top 50 B schools are hugely underinvested. आप अगर आप IIM अहमदाबाद जाएंगे तो आपने admission लिया जुलाई में, September तक आप close कर रहे हो कहाँ आपने किस industry में जाना है, कौन सी internship करनी है, companies आके आपको pitch कर रही हैं. If you go to non-top 50 B school, आपको तो हवा ही नहीं होता पहले साल के January तक की internship भी करनी है summer में.
Right.
So
right.
The internship is the most crucial component because time milta hai 2 mahine pure 24 mahine mein 2 mahine. So good news, Gaurav, is internship also some B schools like Banasthali allow you for 6 months of placement in an internship. So 2 mahine ka to har jagah pe hai sir. But given the critical nature of internship experience, internship is the only way you get to know real life experience of working in a company. Live project aap campus mein pad rahe hain, sath mein live project kar rahe hain, usse nahi hoga. Working from home kar rahe hain, usse nahi. When you go physically to the office, you participate in meetings, you contribute, you collaborate with others, that's the time you really learn the value of MBA education.
Wonderful, sir. Wonderful. So I must tell you know, all the learners that throughout the week, throughout the time, 24 hours, we keep you know, attending our sessions on quants and logical reasoning, data interpretation, verbal ability, reading comprehensions. Simultaneously, you know, we keep talking about group discussions and interviews also. I've taken up initiative and with a lot of support of all of you around, that we can have such you know, great people, you know, who have their experience and they can they are ready to share their experience with us. These candid conversations, this will not directly talk about CAT, this will not directly talk about how do you take this examination. For that also, we would be inviting certain students who cleared it just, you know, a year ago or two, and they'll help us. But here, Mr. Puneet Modgil, as a wonderful friend, I must request, sir, that my students, our students here listening to us, you know, after this also they'll be watching this video. I would like to, you know, I would like you to extend your helping hand to these students. And how do they reach out to you? Can they reach out to you on your social media handles, LinkedIn profile, if they reach out to you? Any ways, you know, regarding their MBA, if they would like to, I would request from the entire Unacademy team that please be there for them, sir. And as we have now very less time, so I would like to
ask you or request you rather to give your closing statement to all our learners who are aspiring for MBA, maybe after 2 years, maybe after 3 years, or after a month only they're going to join B school. What would you advise them?
MBA is a fairly intensive 2 year journey of self-exploration, self-expression and experimentation. आप 2 साल MBA करने जा रहे हैं तो भेड़ चाल में मत रुकिए. You're not part of a herd. If you do an MBA like a herd, सब कर रहे हैं, मैं भी MBA कर लूंगा, then you've not utilized the best value of your money and time. Then you might as well do a job after your graduation and build industry experience. If you're committing yourself full time 2 years for nothing more but intensive experience of trying different options. Gaurav sir, I give an example of going to an MBA program like going to a buffet with 150 dishes that you can choose from. Actually, 60 dishes you can choose from. Right. You can sample everything, then you will know whether you're a finance person, marketing person, and then choose one. So if you are in that spirit of curiosity, seeking your own answers, experimentation, most MBAs, they join and they're focused just on kahan jaake naukri lagni hai. Aap experiment to karo. Finance देखो, marketing देखो, statistics देखो, economics देखो, sample those 55-60 subjects you'll be taught in 2 years and then select the ones which appeal to you more. If you go in that journey of self-transformation, not fixated with CTC only, not fixated with MNC brand to join, I think we'll be in a better shape.
Wonderful, sir. Wonderful. So guys, if you liked the idea of having a candid conversation with senior professionals, leaders, like we have Puneet sir here, do let us know in your comments. Do like the video, take it to the right people, make it, give it a reach as far as possible. Give it to, send it to right people who would get their answers, whatever the doubts they have, confusions they have. So, aap log apne questions ko comment box mein dal dijiye. I would request, sir, jab sabko samay milega, wo baat karenge aapse. You can always reach out to him on LinkedIn, search by his name, thoda sa koshish karo, mehnat karo, aise chahoge dil se, to Ram mil jayenge. Theek hai? So, that's all from our side. Thank you very much, Puneet, sir. It's an honor, honestly. From the entire Unacademy team, I have a sense of gratitude that you could take out time and you could help our learners here. Thank you very much, sir.